I've been recording full time for 7 years, I got to a place where I grew so tired of the sound. It like wore me out. Just the sound, everything being transients popping and the coldness and the brightness and just the sound of digital. Man, you go through that Studer 800 and the CLASP, forget about it. I mean, there's no comparison, absolutely no comparison. It absolutely blows away just going digital. One of the coolest things about this whole CLASP thing is you play better. Right, Dan?
Yeah, well, the monitoring feels real now. I mean,
it's perfectly in time.
If you're used to Pro Tools, there's a certain amount of delay that you just get used to and you accept it as part of your playing, and it could feel like a pocket issue and it could feel like anything. But, you know, being that I play live a lot and then I come into the studio and all of a sudden it sounds like I'm actually playing again, and it was eye-opening. I never noticed the problem until the problem wasn't there.
We're finishing a bunch of records. So we buy the 16-track Studer 800, we buy the CLASP, and we start doing overdub guitars. And the overdub guitars through the Studer and the CLASP are just annihilating the original tracks. No comparison. But the beautiful part about this is that we still work in a digital realm. It's really a hybrid. I mean, we haven't flipped the studio to a thing where like we no longer are Pro Tools and it's just analog. It's like we're bridging the gap between digital and analog. For me, it was a total leap of faith. I bought the Studer not knowing if it was going to be cool. I bought the CLASP not knowing if it was going to be cool. I bought $2,000 in cables, not knowing if it was connecting up anything that was going to be cool. So it was a leap of faith, and it was the best investment I've ever, one of the best investments I've ever made, and everything ended up really being exactly what I had read about, and exactly what people had told me it was going to be about, and more. I got turned on a CLASP initially really through Dave Cobb. And I went over to his studio. He's got an A800 in CLASP, basically the same setup I have here. And I heard what he was doing over there. And I was just like, forget it, man. It's just, there's no plug-in. There's no plug-in that exists that will get you where you get with this in a heartbeat. And Greg, the guy that mixes here, has been tracking a lot. And he's feeling like, wow, mixing's going to be a lot easier because I don't have to mix around everything. Like, it's already there. Now it's just a matter of making it all cool. It's not like I'm trying to figure out how to get 10 puzzle pieces to go together that aren't really going together. It's like now we've got this cohesive sound. The sound of the tape machine is on every track. The customer service with this company and this analog is just incredible. I mean, we were struggling here the other night and Chris came over. He flew in from Nashville and came right to my studio with like bronchitis. And didn't leave until we had everything fixed. And the problem that we actually were really having was the calibration on our Apogees was off. But it took the whole troubleshooting, figuring out, is it cables, is it this, is it the tape machine? We brought in Charlie Bolas to scope everything. I mean, it was this whole process, and when we got to the end, we realized that the issue was in the Apogees. It wasn't in either one of the new gear, but he stayed here all night, sick as a dog, with his lovely wife, and didn't leave until we were making music. And that's customer service, man. That's the real deal, man. So, CLASP, baby.